You are very busy IP attorney. You run a very successful law firm, which is an intellectual property boutique. And you also teach at institutions like National Law School of India University, IIMB, and many more. And I just heard from Sanjeev that you are on multiple ethics committees of multiple companies, and you also work with the United Nations. And passion drives you to write, and you are an avid blogger. And you've also written about 12 books in the past 10 years. So, how do you strike a balance between your work life and your passion? And where do you draw a line between your profession and passion?
I think, as all of you know, I am a full-time intellectual property attorney. That's my breadwinner. However, I love writing and I enjoy writing. A lot of times when I write, I get great clarity in my mind. And so because writing helps me so much, I always find time to write. In my normal course on an everyday basis, I spend at least 2 hours every day to write. On an average, I probably pen down 2,000 words every day. These 12 books are a mere reflection of a small part of my writing that I do every day.
So you carry your corporate approach towards your passion also?
To some extent, I'm one of those guys who is always driven by some kind of result. So I make sure that I have my two hours every day to write. If not for any other reason, just because I enjoy.
I'm sure you have a very luxury demanding clients, and you are always pressed for time when it comes to your work. So does it come in your way of writing at all?
It does. I would say a couple of days in a week when I have a project that I have to finish and I have to stay back in the office until late, I probably don't get to write. That makes me feel slightly bad because I've not done something that I like a lot. So I try to make up for it over the weekend.
That's good.
Basically started writing because I always have enjoyed creative writing. It's just that I was writing for several years but I never published anything. So you probably assume that I started writing in 2013 because I published my first work then. I have always been writing. I've never published it. I've probably never put it up anywhere. I'm speaking about my creative writing works. If you look at my first novel is also revolves around patents, pharma patents, drugs. So even my writings at some level are related to my profession, that is intellectual property. So first novel I wrote about patents, second novel I wrote about copyrights, and on two topics, patents and access to medicines and drugs, which is something that is hotly debated. So I wanted to give a flavor of this topic to the common man in the form of an interesting story. Same thing I did with copyright piracy, films and copyright piracy and so on. In fact, The Oath is the first book which doesn't relate to intellectual property. It's based primarily on criminal law and medical ethics. So if you look at it, the transition, if you look at it from the IP point of view, intellectual property point of view, I just moved from academic writing to fiction writing.
You being a medical...
You either publish through a traditional publisher. That's what I did for all my first 7 books. I published with Oxford University Press, Manupatra, Thompson, some good publishing houses and some decent publishing houses. My first work, first novel was published by Lipstadt, a traditional publishing house. Now, if you publish through a traditional publishing house, the publisher does a part of the work for you, that is he prints the book and probably makes it available in a few stores. But to make the book really popular, the author has to put in a lot of effort in promotion, marketing. The author has to treat the book like a product, like any other product in the market. Now, if you come to self-publishing or publishing your own book to self-publishing platforms, then you are an end-to-end businessman. You are looking at how much money is going into publication of your book, how much returns can you get, and whether these returns are going to encourage you to write one more book or not. So all self-published authors, so the last 5 books I have published have been self-published by myself, and you know, I treat them as, I write because I have the passion to write, but I treat each one of them as a product and see how far we can take the product.
Yeah, it's, I mean